Not pleased by external gains, not saddened by personal losses. Good morning, today is Thursday, May 30, 2024. Today in history, on this day 246 years ago, Voltaire, the eminent 18th century French Enlightenment thinker, writer, and philosopher, passed away. His notable works include Philosophical Correspondence, The Age of Louis XIV, and Candide. Voltaire held a prominent position in the French bourgeois Enlightenment, earning titles such as the King of French Thought, France's Best Poet, and the Conscience of Europe. He made substantial contributions to the advancement and evolution of European thought. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Thousands protest Israeli airstrikes in Paris. According to Agence France-Presse, on May 27, thousands of demonstrators gathered near the Israeli embassy in Paris, chanting pro-Palestinian slogans in protest against Israel's deadly bombing of Rafah, a city in the southern Gaza Strip. Rippy, a representative of the Association France-Palestine Solidarity, expressed outrage, stating, "We can no longer tolerate massacres." A banner displayed at the rally depicted French President Macron, US President Biden, and Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu, labeling them as murderers who dehumanize people. The Paris Police Department estimated that approximately 10,000 people participated in the demonstration. The protest came after Israel bombed a tent camp housing displaced persons in Rafah on May 26, resulting in the deaths of 45 people, including 23 women, children, and the elderly, and injuring 249 others. Israel faced international condemnation for the attack. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu described the incident as a tragic accident and pledged to investigate further. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. Iran's uranium stockpile nears nuclear threshold. According to Reuters, on May 27, two confidential reports from the United Nations nuclear watchdog revealed that Iran's uranium enrichment stockpile is steadily approaching the threshold required to produce a nuclear bomb. Iran's enriched uranium purity has reached 60%, nearing the level needed for weapons-grade uranium, which is around 90%. By May 11, Iran's uranium stockpile had increased by 20.6 kilograms in the quarter, totaling 142.1 kilograms. Subsequently, Iran diluted 5.9 kilograms of enriched uranium into lower-level nuclear material. This implies that, by International Atomic Energy Agency standards, Iran now possesses sufficient enriched uranium to achieve a 60% purity level. If further enriched, Iran could potentially construct 3 nuclear bombs and additional lower-level nuclear weapons. It's been 18 months since the International Atomic Energy Agency's 35 members last passed a resolution against Iran, urging Iran to cooperate with the agency's ongoing investigation into the discovery of uranium particles at 3 undisclosed facilities. However, negotiations between the International Atomic Energy Agency and Iran have stalled following the recent helicopter crash that killed Iranian President Raisi. Myanmar's Rakhine State war escalates, Rohingya affected. Recent reports from Dhaka indicate a worrying escalation in the conflict between government forces and the Arakan army in Myanmar's Rakhine State. This resurgence of violence poses a severe threat to the Rohingya population, with tens of thousands fleeing to Bangladesh since mid-May. However, Bangladesh has closed its border crossings, refusing to accept more refugees. Meanwhile, those Rohingya who remain in Rakhine State urgently require humanitarian assistance. In early May, the Arakan army claimed control of the border town of Buthadong in Rakhine State. The group has been accused of targeting Rohingya civilians in the conflict, although the Arakan army denies these accusations. According to reports from CNN, after seizing control of Buthadong, the Arakan army allegedly set fire to Rohingya homes and engaged in looting. Additionally, they confiscated mobile phones from Rohingya residents and threatened them with violence if they attempted to contact relatives abroad. The situation has since escalated, with the Arakan army launching an attack on Mongda, another town with a significant Rohingya population. The United Nations Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs has highlighted the increasing involvement of Rohingya civilians in the conflict. Over 350,000 civilians have been displaced in Rakhine State in recent years, many of whom lack access to basic public services. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. State Bank of Vietnam halts gold auctions. According to Vietnam News Agency, recently, in order to continue effectively implementing the guidance of the government and the Prime Minister on dealing with the significant disparities between domestic and international gold prices, the State Bank of Vietnam stated that it will adjust the plan to stabilize gold market prices, cease gold bar auctions, and will implement an alternative stabilization plan starting from June 3. Prior to this, in order to implement the guidance of the Prime Minister, conduct gold auctions, and increase market supply, from April 19 this year to now, the National Bank has held 9 SJC gold bar auctions, 6 of which were successful, with the winning number of gold bars being 48,500 taels. However, 3 auctions failed due to insufficient participation from bidding companies. Experts believe that the goal of the National Bank's gold auctions is to increase supply, offset market demand, and cool down gold prices, but this has not been achieved. The reason is that in order for the price of gold to fall, the reference price of each auction needs to be close to the international gold price. However, in the 9 gold bar auctions conducted, the reference price proposed by the National Bank was equivalent to the previous day's gold closing price, which was much higher than the international gold price, making it difficult to stabilize the gold market. Currently, the State Bank of Vietnam has instructed all provincial and municipal branches to closely monitor local gold market prices, as well as gold buying and selling points, and to report immediately if there is a queue to buy gold. Now, here is some important safety information. Storms hit Bangladesh, India, leaving millions without power. On May 26, Cyclone Rimal made landfall in coastal areas of Bangladesh and India, according to Reuters. The Indian Meteorological Department reported that the storm affected the coastal regions near Mangla Port in Bangladesh and the Sagar Islands in West Bengal, India, with winds reaching speeds of 135 km per hour. The impact was significant, with many thatched houses losing their roofs, mud houses being flattened, numerous power poles falling, trees uprooted, and millions left without electricity. Approximately 800,000 people were relocated to shelters in Bangladesh from Mangla Port, Chittagong districts, and 9 coastal areas. In India, around 110,000 individuals were evacuated to shelters, while authorities are still assessing the full extent of the damage caused by the cyclone. Typhoon Winnier sweeps Philippines, 8,000 plus flee homes. As reported by Agence France-Presse, Typhoon Winnier, this year's first major typhoon, made landfall on Samar Island in the central Philippines on the evening of May 24. It then swept northwest towards the main island of Luzon, where it lingered near the capital, Manila. The typhoon brought heavy rainfall, resulting in flooding that forced over 8,000 individuals to evacuate their homes. Disaster relief officials in Quezon Province reported coastal areas experiencing floodwaters as high as 3 meters, with widespread power outages. Tragically, 2 fatalities were reported due to falling trees, including a 14-year-old boy. In neighboring Laguna Province, over 2,000 people sought refuge as more than half of the 30 cities experienced flooding. Images shared on social media by local government agencies depicted rescuers using inflatable boats to evacuate stranded individuals. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Singapore discovers drug-free cancer-fighting method. According to reports from Singapore, scientists at the National University of Singapore have made a breakthrough in cancer treatment. They have discovered a drug-free, non-invasive method that utilizes electromagnetic pulses to stimulate muscle cells, potentially aiding cancer patients in conventional treatments. Led by Associate Professor Alfredo Franco Obregon from the Institute of Healthcare Technology and Innovation, the research team found that when exposed to short, mild pulses of electromagnetic fields, muscle cells produce and release proteins with anti-cancer properties. These molecules can travel through the bloodstream, offering protection against cancer throughout the body. The study initially tested this approach at the cellular level, demonstrating that magnet therapy inhibited the growth, invasion, and migration of breast cancer cells, key indicators of cancer progression. Furthermore, magnetically stimulated muscle cells showed promise in reducing the size of small tumors and tumor vascularization. Clinical trials are underway to assess the anti-cancer potential of magnetic therapy targeting muscle cells, with researchers also aiming to identify additional anti-cancer biomarkers produced and released by muscle cells. Financial newsletter. On May 28, Shanghai silver surged nearly 2% during the day and over 4% at night. Spot silver also rose sharply by more than 4%, despite New York silver futures being closed. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.